Welcome to this presentation on CAN and Flexray protocol comparison. In this video, we will see what are the features of CAN and what are the features of Flexray protocol and how they are different from each other. Okay, with respect to number of lines, CAN is used basically to reduce the number of wires going in and around the vehicle. Let us see the comparison with respect to number of wires the CAN and the Flexray use. CAN uses two wires, which is called as CAN high and CAN low. Flexray also makes use of two wires, which is called as bus plus and bus minus. Okay, with respect to speed, CAN operates at max bit rate of 1 Mbps. Usually, for most of the automotive applications, the industry don't go for 1 Mbps. Usually, they set it for 500 kbps. Whereas, Flexray is 10 times faster than CAN, which has got 10 Mbps max bit rate. Triggering. Okay, the CAN is an event triggered. So, if any message to be sent, some event should happen. So, it's an event triggered protocol. Whereas, Flexray is a time triggered as well as event triggered protocol. I will explain more about why time driven as well as event driven in the upcoming slides. Okay, what about the communication architecture? Okay, so CAN is a multi-master network. So there is no master-slave network over here. Everybody is master. Anybody is free to send data at any point of time. So there is no one master which will control the bus. Everybody is master over here. Anybody has any data to be sent, they can send if bus is free. Flexray is also like a multi-master communication network. Here also you don't have master-slave network. Here also everybody is a master. Anybody has data to be sent, they can send the data at any point of time. But when you compare with CAN, Flexray, in the previous question you saw, Flexray has both static segment as well as a dynamic segment. So there is a slot allocated for every node in the static segment. So during that slot, node can send the data. And it also has a optional dynamic segment, okay, where they can compute for the bus dynamically. Okay, bus conflict, as I just mentioned, CAN uses an arbitration process to resolve the bus conflict, whereas Flexray has two different segments, the static segment and a dynamic segment. So in the static segment, it makes use of time division multiple access. Okay, a slot is allocated for every node. During that slot, a node can transmit the data. Okay, and there is something called as dynamic segment, where they can compute for the bus dynamically. Okay, so it is called as a flexible time division multiple access. Okay, time division multiple access, flexible time division multiple access. So noise elimination. How noise is eliminated in CAN and Flexray? So both CAN and Flexray both uses a differential voltage logic, okay, to eliminate the noises. For example, both uses two wires. So if there are noise present on the lines, so when you subtract, so the noise gets eliminated. So that is the reason they make use of a differential voltage concept.